A very good morning to all. Myself Dr. Ansar Ahmed, and in this lecture I'm going to cover matters of obtaining statistical parameter for random process. In the previous lectures we have gone through the modeling of telephone traffic which is based on random process. Why this is based on random process, or why we use random process to design telecom traffic, already we have discussed this thing in previous lecture. So today we will see what are the methods, okay, or the mechanism to obtain a statistical parameter for random process. Of course we use random process, but how things takes place, or how we need to get the statistical parameters. So methods of obtaining a statistical parameter for random process, which has the statistical properties of a random process, may be obtained in two ways. So it may be obtained in two ways. First one is time statistical method, and second is ensemble statistical method. What actually is this? Statics. Actually these are the statics which we collect to design telephone exchange or telephone traffic, which is very unpredictable because of the many factors, and one very important factor is the human behavior. So as we have seen that the human factor and the season of the year are very important to design any telephone traffic. So by using these methods we collect the statics, and that statics is used to design that telephone traffic in the network. Though it may be not 100% correct, but somewhere it works. So what are those or how we collect the statics? Let's see. We collect by two ways: time statistical method and ensemble statistical method. Statistical properties of a random process. Statistical properties of a random process may be obtained by observing its behavior over a very long period of time. Okay, so whatever statics we get, first of all we need to observe its behavior for a very long time, which is known as time statistical method, because it is based on time. That's why this is called time statistical method. So whatever is happening in that time, on the basis of that time the traffic is designed. This is the time average or time statistical method. These are the amplitude, this is the amplitude, and this is the time. Okay, so that duration of time we observe the statics in the network. Okay, so what is happening, this is sometimes it is low, then sometimes it is high, then it is low, then again it goes to high, then low, then constant, and it goes on. So for that duration of time, just you can see for that duration of time we observe the graph, and you can see that a lot of zigzag or high low in the graph, or this is also the fluctuation with respect to time to the amplitude. Amplitude may be that is number of things which we are observing. So one time it is high, other time it is low, sometimes it is constant, and thus things are goes on. Ensemble statistical property. What happened in ensemble statics? Statistical properties of a random process may be obtained by observing simultaneously a very large number of statically identical random sources at any given instant of time, which is called ensemble static property. So here we observe many things but with the same duration of time. Okay, we can get this thing ensemble average, that is this is one source, this is one source, this is two source, and this is like n sources. Okay, and these are the amplitude and this is the time. So for this period of time, in this period of time we observe simultaneous or many sources. I mean, see here, this is the thing which we are going to consider for this one. Okay, so for this duration of time, I mean the time is constant and we are observing this static. So we will average out what is the average of all three sources, and then taking the average we use the static, that is statics. Okay, time statistical method. We can compare the above method of obtaining a statistical parameter for random process are analogous to determining the statistical behavior of a dash in two fashions. Okay, so time statistical method may be obtained by taking the example of a dice, by throwing dice for a very large number of time. Just you Ludo, if you are playing a Ludo and you use a dice, in that case by throwing dice for a very large number of times. So one may be that is you throw a dice for a long time. Okay, just it is taking distance and time, it is covering distance and time. Or by throwing a very large number of identical dice all together and observing the outcome. The other thing that is we threw many dice simultaneously and we observed the statics of that dice. Okay, in the first case a particular outcome would occur 1/16th of the time the experiment is performed. So actually we are comparing ensemble and time statistical method. So in first time statistical method we threw one dice for a long time and just we see the result, it will be equal to 1/6. Okay, while in second case 1/6 of the outcome could correspond to a particular face value of the site, because we are throwing many dice and just we are observing what numbers we are getting. This the statistical parameters obtained in either case are the same. So both somewhere things are same in both the methods. Okay, in case of random process the ensemble and time statics need not the same for two reasons. If they may be same, if they are not same they may be differ. So what are the reason to be different? Statistical properties of a random process themselves vary with time, in which case the ensemble static will be different instant of time. Okay, got it? Statistical properties of a random process themselves vary with time, in which case the ensemble static will be different instant of, because it varies so it may be different time. In order that the ensemble and time statics are the same, it is necessary but not sufficient that the statistical parameter of the random process under consideration remain unchanged over time. So it may be same or different. Here things are compared. So by these two methods we can get the statics. Random process whose statistical parameter don't change time with time are known as stationary process. Okay, random process whose statistical parameters, what parameters we are going, and if they are don't change with the time, then these are called stationary process. Okay, random process while have identical time and ensemble average are known as ergodic process. In the first case it may be time, in time statistical method it may be stationary, and in ensemble when the process have identical time and an Ansible average is known as ergodic process. It may be noted that ergodic process is stationary, where is stationary process need not necessarily ergodic. Okay, so this is saying that ergodic process is stationary, may be stationary, while stationary process need not necessarily ergodic. In some random process, the mean and the variance alone are not stationary, and other high order moments may vary with time. Such process is known as wide sense stationary process. Okay, so it was the methods to find the statics to design the telecom traffic, which is very unpredictable in nature. So by time statistical method, which has ensemble and that process, we can design by that one. So guys, it was all about that time statistical method. As we know, teletraffic is non-stationary, which is difficult to design. Okay, because it cannot be stationary. I mean, if anyone want to make the call, so it may be fast or slow, but there may be, it can't be stationary, but that all the time that is 5 users or 10 users are making the call. Sometimes number of users may be more, sometimes it may be less, and sometimes there may be no user. So tele traffic is non stationary. The mean and the variance of the traffic are different during different time of the day. Because of the random behavior of the human being or the season, which is based on the season of the year, so the mean and the variance of the traffic may be different during the different time of the day. Okay, it cannot be fixed all the times. We cannot have same density of subscriber. If the traffic is considered in segment of the day, say 6, 9, 10, 11 etc, the traffic may be considered to be stationary and easy to design. So if the traffic is considered in segment of the day, say 6 to 9, 10 to 11 etc, the traffic may be considered to be stationary and easy to design. Okay, so for particular period of time, it may be stationary, but not all the times. And if for particular time it is stationary, it may be easy to design. So guys, it was all about the today lecture. That is, there were two methods. I mean, we started from here. There are two methods, time statistical and ensemble. In time statistical method, we collect the statics with respect to the time, and by just observing the things for the longer time. But in ensemble statistical methods, we set the time, we take the things for particular time, and take the many sources. I mean, what is happening or how they are behaving with respect to the time. So it was all about today methods. Till then, take care and have a great time.